Copyright disclaimer. Citation of articles and authors in this report does not imply ownership. Works and images presented here fall under Fair Use Section 107 and are used for commentary on globally significant newsworthy events. Under Section 107 of the Copyright Act, 1976, allowance is made for fair use for purposes such as criticism, comment, news reporting, teaching, scholarship, and research. Community Guidelines Disclaimer. The points of view and purpose of this video is not to bully or harass anyone, but rather share that opinion and thoughts with other like-minded individuals curious about the subject.
Hello, UCU family members and comic heads out there! This is your friendly host, Ninjetta Kage of United Comics Universe, where we cover all things that deal with comics. Before I get into this comic hypeness, let's get into the giveaways! We will be giving away a PlayStation 4 once we reach that 5,000 subscriber mark. Or the PlayStation 5, it'll be your choice when that time comes for you to pick one out. Also, when we hit that 500 subscriber mark, we'll be giving away a Nick Fury Pop. Moving on. In order to be a winner of these awesome prizes here at the channel, all you have to do is comic smash that subscribe button, then comic punch that notification bell so you can get notified when we go live and upload a video. Welcome to your
United Comics Universe.
A universe for fans.
From pages to pictures, we are comics.
We are movies, we are television, we are the pages in your books, and we are comics. Agatha Harkness's mysterious book. Could it be the Necronomicon? Okay, have you noticed in WandaVision we kept hearing a lot of talking about bringing people back from the dead? For example, remember when Tommy said to his mother, "You can fix anything, fix dead." Agatha even said at that moment to Wanda, "You can do that?" Now we know why Agatha asked Wanda that. Or, remember when S.W.O.R.D. director Tyler Hayward said this to Wanda, "Not everyone has that kind of power to bring their soulmate back online." Or, even when Agatha said this to Wanda about her brother, "Necromancy was a non-starter since your real brother's body is on another continent, not to mention full of holes." So, what Evanora Harkness was referring to when she told Agatha, "But yet you have betrayed your coven, you have stolen magic over your age of station, your practice the darkness of magic," was the Necronomicon, because necromancy is dark magic. The Necronomicon has the dark spells to bring the dead back according to the witch's lore. The Necronomicon was a powerful tome of black magic created by Abdul al-Hazred, the Mad Arab, in the 8th century. It was one of the most powerful tomes on magic and presumably magnified Al-Hazred's power. So now a little background on Abdul al-Hazred. Abdul al-Hazred was born in the 8th century in Saudi Arabia. The same century he created the legendary Necronomicon, a powerful black magic tome patterned after the Darkhold or inspired by it. Abdul was considered a superhuman and has a number of magical abilities. He can teleport, usually appearing and disappearing in a cloud of green smoke, and mesmerize others. He has superhuman strength and durability, but this may only be a reflection of his ability to control the perception of others. He is also able to summon demons from another realm. He is shown to withstand a direct gunshot at the head without suffering any damage, as if the bullet was swallowed by the shade under his hood, or take a punch of Logan in the gut without even moving. Speaking of Logan, while trying to take over Tiger Tiger Syndicate and Major Rapport, Abdul hired a group of various mercenaries to kidnap Tiger Tiger and Archie Corrigan, which included Stump, Sheik, Scarface, Dumas, Riss, and Ferret, aka Chief. When Abdul encountered Wolverine, he sent demons against him. His plan backfired and Abdul was banished to the realm of his demons. Abdul al-Hazred possibly could show up since he has connection to Madripoor and we're having the Falcon and Winter Soldier show coming up. Also, it is very possible that Wolverine might show up. Oh yeah, necromancy. Could it be possible that Agatha has the legendary Necronomicon? Agatha Harkness's mysterious book. Could it be the Darkhold? The Darkhold was created by Ch'thon. Ch'thon is one of the most powerful elder gods of Earth, who has degenerated into a demonic state. He has the vast ability to manipulate magical energies for a variety of effects. He has manifested himself in human form, but can take various forms, His true form, if he has one, has not been revealed. Chthon has an extraordinary knowledge of the dark mystical forces of the cosmos and cataloged the evil spells of the demonic elder gods of Earth in the Darkhold. He is the original author of the Darkhold, which is an indestructible collection of evil mystical knowledge and spells that he intended to serve as the medium through which he could return to Earth. The Darkhold can apparently change its form, since Chthon created it millions of years before the rise of humanity, to whom it appeared as a set of scrolls with human writing upon them. Most people who use the Darkhold spells fall under Chthon's mental control as a result. Only humans with great spiritual strength, or aided by great mystical expertise, like Dr. Strange and the members of the Montessi family, can successfully resist this mental enslavement. The Darkhold's power is so vast it took the combined strength and will of both Merlin, the most accomplished Earth sorcerer of all time, and Brendan to contain it, and even together they were unable to destroy it or its power. Chthon has mastery over dark and chaos magic. He is a being of unimaginable mystical power, specifically that which can be called black magic and chaos magic. This magic can manipulate, warp, and reconstruct the very fabric of existence and reality to the user's very whims, and bring about total destruction to the cosmos. He also has other realm control. In the dimension which he created for himself, he controls every aspect of reality. And telepathy. This ability enables him to read, control, and communicate with the minds of others, even across dimensional barriers. For the other connection, until Chthon finds a way to truly free himself from his other dimensional realm, he can operate on Earth through his elemental host, known as the Other, which is summoned when someone uses the Darkhold. The Other can manifest itself in any appearance it wants, but its actions on the earthly sphere are generally limited by the demands of the user of the Darkhold. He also has demonic possession. If the proper rituals are performed, Chthon can also take over mortal host bodies on Earth, but he cannot easily transfer all of his totality to these forms, and often even the fraction he can is too much for the form to contain. Chthon had possessed Scarlet Witch. She was eventually freed from Chthon's possession by Doctor Strange during the final battle against Hydra. We've been hearing rumors that Wanda is going to be a villain in Doctor Strange 2, so is it possible that Chthon might possess Wanda? We'll see. Wanda would be a great vessel for him because she has all the same powers he does, chaos, magic, other realm control, telepathy, etc. One of the big things I noticed that Ralph Halley, sounds familiar, right? That's because it's Agatha Harkness' husband, and he could have possibly owned the book. Agatha Harkness' mysterious book. Could it be the Book of Shumagorath? Shumagorath was one of the Great Old Ones, also named Many Angled Ones. At some point, Shumagorath created Quoggoth as a servant. During Earth's prehistory, Shumagorath ruled the world and demanded human sacrifice until eventually banished by the time-traveling sorceress Sisse-Nig. The entity eventually returns during the Hyborian Age, but it is imprisoned within a mountain by the power of the god Crom. Shumagorath continues to be an influence on Earth until returned to its home dimension by Crom. When the entity tries to return to Earth via the mind of the Ancient One, his disciple, Doctor Strange, is forced to kill him to prevent this. Years later, Strange battles Shumagorath in its home dimension, and although victorious, he eventually becomes a new version of the entity. Strange sacrifices himself to prevent this transformation and is resurrected by an ally. Sorcerer Nicholas Scratch summons the entity to Earth, but it is driven back by the combined efforts of Doctor Strange, the Fantastic Four, the Salem Seven, and villain Diablo. Shumagorath is eventually revealed to be one of the four undying, extra-dimensional, multi-angled ones, guiding a metaphysical invasion from a dimension called the Cancerverse. In an attempt to destroy death itself, the entity and its allies are rendered inert by the conceptual form of death and subsequently are trapped in the Cancerverse when it is destroyed. Shumagorath survives and once again attempts to invade Earth, but is repelled by the superhero team The Avengers with the Spear of Destiny. During the 2011 Fear Itself storyline, Shumagorath is among the demons to meet at the Devil's Advocacy to discuss the threat of the Serpent and what this means to them. During the 2013 Infinity storyline, Thanos' servant Emily Ma manipulates Doctor Strange into summoning Shumagorath to the streets of New York. The creature is met by Luke Cage and his new team of Avengers. Blue Marvel arrives at the scene of the battle and flies through Shumagorath's head, destroying its physical manifestation. Shumagorath's astral body possesses a crowd of people in New York City, and attempts to recreate itself on Earth. It is weakened through mystical attacks by Power Man and White Tiger, and is finally banished by Monica Rambeau, who penetrates Shumagorath's eye as a ray of light and disperses the entity from within. Last Days of Magic storyline describes Shumagorath as responsible for destroying the home planet of the character Imperator, leader of the Empiricol, by sending a group of evil sorcerers after his family. This leaves the Imperator to dedicate his life to destroying magic in every universe. Later, during a battle, Dormammu states to Doctor Strange that he helped the Empiricol in finding Shumagorath, who was defeated by the Imperator. Doctor Strange later banishes Dormammu to Shumagorath itself, who is visibly wounded and seeking revenge. Shumagorath is an ancient force of chaos, the immortal, nigh invincible, and godlike ruler of nearly 100 alternate universes, capable of energy projection, shape-shifting, teleportation, levitation, altering reality, and sympathetic magic, among many other feats. He is described as being vastly more powerful than other mighty demonic enemies such as Satanish and Mephisto, and is capable of automatically destroying multiple galaxies through aura pressure alone. So what do you guys think about this? So use your comic words and put them down below to let us know. Like up, but the more important thing is to share, share, share. This is the only way we can get around the censorship, so please share. Remember, sharing is caring. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. This will also help us fight back against censorship and force the YouTube algorithm to share this video. Hit us up on Instagram, Twitter, Parler, Rumble, and Facebook. Please support us on Patreon or support us on PayPal. All links are down below. We are comics. Catch you superheroes and villains another time.